Good morning, students. We have studied the three states of matter and the interconversion of matter. That is solid to a liquid, liquid to a gas to a liquid, and liquid to a solid. Now, next we will study arrangement. Arrangement of molecules. How are these molecules arranged in case of your three states of matter? See here, inside any matter, we said there are atoms. These atoms, they are combining to form molecules. Okay. Now here, let us say arrangement of molecules in solids. Like, let us take our brick example. All these molecules are arranged. See, in solids the molecules are arranged in this pattern. In a liquids, these are the arrangement of molecules in solids, liquids, and gases. Now, by looking through these figures, can I say in solids are the molecules tightly packed? Yes. In the case of solids, the molecules are tightly packed. Now look at your liquids. How are those compared with your solid? They are a little bit loosely packed. Yes or no? Okay. Now compare your gas and a liquid. Gases are very much loosely packed. Okay, gases are very much loosely packed. Hence, by the arrangement of these molecules, by looking at the figures itself, we can say that here the solids have the molecules being tightly packed, and your liquids, they are a little bit loosely packed, and your gases are very much loosely packed. Okay. Now we will differentiate between a solid, liquid, and a gas. How to differentiate here? Solids, when you take a brick, a pen, a pencil, these are all solids. About the shape, let us see. First thing is a property called as a shape. Solids, do they have a definite shape? Yes, they will have a definite shape. What about the liquids? Say liquids, let us take 100 ml of water in a beaker. 100 ml of water, the same 100 ml of water in a pot, the same 100 ml of water in a conical flask. Now, what is the shape of the water? What can you say? If you pour it in a glass, it will take the shape of the glass. If we pour it in a beaker, it will take the shape of a beaker. If we take it in a pot, it will take the shape of a pot. Hence, solids have definite shape. What happened to the liquids? They will take the shape of a container. Okay? They will take the shape like pot or anything, glass, beaker, conical flask. If you want to find out the shape, it will take the shape of the container. Okay, children? Next is your gases. How are the gases? After they have definite shape, they will take the shape of the container. And next we will find out the volume. Solids have fixed volume. Okay? Because the volume means the space occupied by any object is called as a volume. See, if I take a pencil, put it in a container, move the container randomly, in any way you move it, does the volume of the pencil or the shape of the pencil changes? No. Hence, for the solids, they have a fixed volume. For liquids, see, your milkman may be getting the milk or oil, if you see. On the oil packets also, you will be seeing 1 liter. Okay. They have fixed volume. Gases, they do not have. Okay. Next. Fluidity means flowing. Does solids flow? If I place a pencil on the bench or a floor, does it flow? No. Your solids will not flow. Now when you come to liquids, you have been seeing water. Does water flow? Yes. Gases? If I open the gas in a cylinder, it flows in all directions. Yes or no? That is nothing but fluidity. Next is compressibility. Solids. If I take a sponge, if I press it, it becomes compressed. Okay? Your solids, liquids and gases. Gases can easily compressed. Okay? Your liquids a little bit compressed. Solids like a brick. Can you compress the brick? No. Okay? Liquids can show a little bit compressibility and gases can show more compressibility. These are certain differences between a solid, liquid and a gas. Next, after these arrangement of the molecules, we have a small topic in this chapter. See, in between the molecules, is there a certain gaps or a space? That space we call it as intermolecular space. In between the molecules, see here, gap is there. A gap is there. A gap is there. Okay? That space is called intermolecular space. Is there a gap? Yes. In which case do you see more gap? In case of gases. See, more the intermolecular space, less is the force of attraction. Okay. In here, space is less. Can I say the force between the molecules is more in solids? Yes. Here, intermolecular space is less when compared to a solids. Hence, the intermolecular force of attraction is weak when compared to a solids. Following, children, intermolecular space is less in case of solids, hence force of attraction will be more. This is also called as intermolecular force. Intermolecular space is more when compared to your solids, hence your intermolecular force will be a little bit slightly less. Okay, here intermolecular space is more. What happens to the intermolecular force of attraction? Will be very much less. Space is more, hence the force of attraction becomes space is more. Force of attraction becomes less. Okay? Like this. This is the arrangement of molecules and their force of attraction and their intermolecular space. If you want, let us see once your textbook. See here, he has given you arrangement of molecules in a solid, liquid and a gas. Look at here, below the table. Intermolecular attraction in solids is maximum, means more. Space will be less. Look at the intermolecular space is minimum. Next, in liquids you see intermolecular attraction is less. Intermolecular force of attraction is less because the space is a little bit more when compared to your solids. Intermolecular space is more. Okay? Gases. See, more intermolecular space means maximum is saying. Comparing your solid, liquid and a gas, more space is there in case of your gas. Hence he is saying maximum. Okay? Like this, the arrangement of molecules and the space we call intermolecular space, and the attraction between the molecules we call it as intermolecular force. Okay, children? Your homework is, note on your homework. In A bit, first, second, third questions, you write them. Okay? And sixth one also you do. First, second, third and sixth. Okay, children? Thank you.